The following is a paid program sponsored by Soul D’licious. Please be advised that the voices and opinions you hear do not necessarily represent the views of KUNV Las Vegas, the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, or the Board of Regents of the Nevada System of Higher Education.
Las Vegas, and welcome to this segment of Soul D’licious Infused. Now welcome your host.
Good morning, Las Vegas. It's a beautiful Saturday morning here in Las Vegas, Nevada. We are Soul D’licious Infused. My name is Benjamin Bay, and I have a guest co-host in here with me today, Bea Martinez. She is the extractor, the head extractor over there at THC Labs. Stephanie can't be with us today because she has millions and millions of meetings. So we're going to let Bea take it away and introduce herself, and then we're going to introduce our guest from Great Basin. We got Garrett on the line, and we got the brewmaster himself. So we're going to talk about what they do at Great Basin, and Bea's going to introduce herself as the new co-host temporary, while Stephanie is out of the room.
Yes, only for today.
Only for today.
Only for today. Hi, I'm Bea.
That's it.
That's pretty much it. That's all you're going to get out of me today.
That's it. So we're going to have a great show today. I'm glad it's Saturday because it's one of those days that you get a chance, the opportunity to kick back, listen to the radio, listen to 91.5 FM, Soul D’licious Infused at KUNV. We do this stuff all the time. This is our seventh show now, and we got the best folks coming on the seventh show, Great Basin, because you know what they do? They brewery. We getting ready to put this thing together with THC Labs and put it in a what they call it, a little pen, huh? You guys gonna do the?
It's a cartridge.
Cartridge.
Yeah.
I don't do cartridges. I smoke it.
It's not for everyone. So a lot of people, most of the time, people tell me that they just smoke, you know, a joint, a blunt, mm-hmm. or whatever mm-hmm. they've rolled.
Pipe, whatever.
Yeah. But not a lot of people are really into cartridges. And those that are have, like, their own, they want something specific. And they know what they want. Because mm-hmm. if you're getting that cartridge, you're expecting something more pristine. Whereas people who roll stuff, they're like, well, this is the best for me. Like, Snoop Dogg will not touch cartridges.
I know that. And so, with that being said, we're going to talk about this Great Basin thing that they're doing about infusing the flavor of the beer in a cartridge so that people can enjoy Great Basin's flavor while they smoke. That's a good one. I like that. So we're going to bring Garrett. You there?
I'm here.
Oh, yeah. He there. And introduce everybody that's on your end of this of the microphone so that we can see everybody with Great Basin.
I've got Tom with me. He's the brewmaster at Great Basin Brewing.
Okay.
And doing the work of putting our beers together ever since 1993 mm-hmm. when he opened. We're in about this most award-winning brewery. And, we've just been brewing beer ever since.
Hmm. So you're the marketing manager for Great Basin, right?
I am, yeah.
Mm-hmm. How long you been doing that?
Oh man, I've been working with Great Basin since about 2011, and then I've been full time on staff ever since about 2.5 years ago.
Mm.
Wow.
Mm, okay. So welcome to the program. You guys are very, very welcome. We want to know as much as we can about what we're about to do. And that's the whole reason why I came together with this show, Soul D’licious Infused, because it's all about everything cannabis in Las Vegas and Nevada. So with Great Basin doing what they're doing, and you, Garrett, and you putting it out there with the marketing and all of that goody old stuff, we're gonna get into some of the questioning so that we can get to it. So from what I'm seeing here, Great Basin has operated its brew pubs and brewery facilities in northern Nevada for more than 25 years, right?
1993.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So is this your first foray in the cannabis space?
Yeah, I'll, this is Tom. I'll answer that a little bit, please, too.
Oh, hey, Tom, how you doing? I'm sorry. You the baddest. You the one with it. So go ahead. Talk to me. Tell me something. I'm glad I'm hearing your voice.
Yeah, well, you know, Garrett, actually, I met Garrett at a beer dinner one time. And at that dinner, he was doing a lot of artwork for a lot of casinos and other things there, too. And we started talking about beer, and his eyes lit up. And he said, my gosh, I'd much rather design ad campaigns for beer than I would for, you know. So that's how we met and things. And since then, he's designed or helped us design a lot of labels. But this whole, cannabis thing and beer, I mean, there's just no beer in the cannabis whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
However, a lot of the aroma and flavors from beer come from hops.
Mm-hmm.
And there's all kinds of hops, different varieties of hops. They figure that, some of them are piney, some of them are fruity, some of them are spicy, and all kinds of different things. And our ichthyosaur, which is named after the state fossil, I was a geologist for many years, and so I thought we were making a big, strong beer. Let's name it after the state fossil, a beast that ruled the seas when back in the Triassic.
Mm-hmm.
We ended up, calling it beer ichthyosaur. I can remember about the first day we opened, some young lady comes up to the bar and says, excuse me, sir, could I have an itchy? And I go, no. That here. But so started to icky for those that are paleontologically challenged and can't pronounce ichthyosaur. But each beer, especially IPAs, have a very interesting and pleasant hop aroma. And that comes from the hops, a variety of different strains of hops late in the process. So we teamed up with the cannabis companies, THC, and decided that we could actually, they could extract some of the oils from these hops and have some of that aroma and flavor that we get from a fine IPA, like our Tectonic Event or Ichthyos or Icky IPA.
Yeah.
And, and then that's a beautiful thing.
That brings me to my next question. What inspired this concept?
You know, ever since we started brewing beer 26 years ago, Great Basin's been pushing what you can do with beer. You know, we've added jalapenos to beer before. We've added berries. We've done all sorts of different things. We once a year we go out and do a harvest ale where we pick sagebrush and native juniper berries, and we throw that in beer. So we're always kind of pushing to see what's next in beer, and when. You know, because hops being the cousin of the cannabis flower, we thought there might be some kind of synergy there. And, after talking to Stephanie at OMG THC, we said, well, let's give it a shot. And and really, it was kind of that curiosity that drove what we're doing today.
So why not do a cannabis-infused non-alcoholic beer?
You know, that would be a great idea, I think, too. We cannot do a cannabis-infused beer.
Uh-huh. Non-alcoholic.
That might be a possibility. I mean, maybe we'll...
They want the part to
get you
high.
Let's not close all doors yet,
right?
Yeah,
I know, they just want the part to get you high. They don't want the part... If you non-alcoholic, I don't think the feds ain't going to come in too much. As long as they don't get you, with the alcohol involved. But I said non-alcoholic, I think that would be great. I think you guys would prosper real big off of something like that.
You might be on to something here.
Yes, indeed. That's why I got this radio show. So I can be on to a lot of stuff. I'm really enjoying this show, though.
Us brewers, you look at the ancient brewing records that goes back 5,000 plus years, and even the brewers back then were looking for new and exciting flavors.
Mm-hmm.
And so there was the world are looking for new and exciting flavors too, so why not team up?
True.
And come up with new and exciting and beautiful flavors.
Mm-hmm. So tell us what you expect. Tell us what to expect from this product from the hop side.
Okay. The hop side, again, we are taking hops that have worked with our Ichthyosaur IPA and blending those together, which give us some really interesting and nice grapefruit and piney aromas. And there's kind of, I think, some really interesting stone fruits, and I look at nectarine-type aromas that come up with those hops, along with
other citrus flavors. Yeah, grapefruit's one of the major ones, too, but there's a nice lime tint to that that's going to come through that will balance the flavors and aromas really, really nicely. Mm-hmm. And it's really interesting, the two different products that we've got. We've got Icky THC, and we've got the Tectonic THC. Mm-hmm. So for Icky, three major hop components that they kind of hop varieties that come together.
And so
when you exhale, you just kind of washes over you.
Yeah. So I understand your team tried some of the earlier samples. What did they think?
You know, when we had a panel of brewers that got together and sampled a few test batches, and OMG THC was great because in our partnership they gave us such a variety of different percentages of hop terpenes to sample.
Mm-hmm.
And really, as soon as we sampled it, we thought that was just a great natural extension of where we wanted this to go. And it was something genuinely new that nobody had ever really experienced before. So it was just a lot of excitement that we felt on our end as soon as we got to try it.
Mm.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I'm really curious as to, so I actually made those samples, and it was a lot of work because they were different percentages. Why did you go with the percentage that you chose? I mean, I went back and forth with like a higher percentage and a lower percentage.
We had a really vigorous debate around it, actually. Each kind of person had their favorite, and we talked about it, and great work. Really, we were all impressed by everything. In the end, I think we kind of went for a middle of the road effect where, you just got that gentle hop aroma without it being too overpowering.
So. Okay. Yeah. Cause it was a lot of back and forth. And then Stephanie would tell me, oh, they didn't like this one, but they like this one. And I was like, oh, I was kind of hoping, you have your own favorites and kind of hoping for a certain number, and you guys went with the one I didn't like, so. I'm kidding. I liked all of them. No, I just really wanted to be in that room where you guys got to pick, because I really wanted to hear the feedback. So this is the first time I'm hearing it, too.
That's because you put them together.
Yeah.
You wanted to hear the feedback on which one that they felt
so
was
it's
great,
interesting.
Which one that they felt wasn't great.
But it's interesting that you picked that number because it really was the middle ground of everything I've done. So,
whoa. Okay.
Yeah. I think that one has to understand we're writing this book here. And, as the old Robert O'Keefe song goes, the road goes on forever and the party never ends. So I think there's more opportunity to have more meetings and come up with more brands because we're just starting this road show. Absolutely.
Oh, okay. Well, that leads me into the next question. Why did you decide to partner with this company called THC and the OMG THC brand?
You know, in getting to know them more and more, it really came down to the quality that they and the high standards that they held themselves to. So, we're all about quality.
Oh, we know we like that.
And go ahead. OMG THC, they held that same high standard of quality for their premium cannabis. So, it just felt natural to us.
Yeah, see, and that's what we're doing. We're infusing seasoning. And I went to them for the same reason. They, quality, man, I mean, customer service, everything is there in that lab. And I understand 100%. I'm with you. Because remember, even though Soul D’licious Infused is the radio show, and I did partner up with Stephanie and them just like you did, they did my infused seasoning, and that's why the radio show has become an existence.
Absolutely.
So you're offering a promotion for Bloom Reno customers who purchases the first batches of product. Tell our listeners about that.
Yeah, so that's right. So for the first 500 people that get into Bloom and buy either a Icky THC or a Tectonic THC, they're going to get a little $2 off coupon.
Okay.
To pick up some paired beer here at any Great Basin location here in Reno.
So
that's awesome.
So will there be will there also be promotions of Las Vegas customers of the Bloom stores here?
Yeah, you know, there will be, and we're working on it. We're finalizing those details right now. So we're encouraging everybody to follow Bloom and OMG THC, you know, and so they can be on that forefront and know as soon as we nail down what that promotion is going to be.
Okay. Now, how long has Tom been? I'll ask you, Tom. How long have you been a brewmaster?
Well, I started brewing in college,
okay.
Which is a long time ago.
Okay.
Yesterday, right?
Yesterday. That was yesterday. Remember that.
Legal to home brew in the state, and illegal to do other things in the state and other
yes,
places
it was.
Too. At that. But anyway, I was. I actually have a degree in geology and a master's in engineering, and I worked in that field for quite a while,
mm-hmm.
Until about the late 80s when I started going to brew schools, and there really aren't that many. Up at UC Davis was the one I attended because they have, at UC Davis, they have all those vineyards up north Napa Valley and things, and so they, a lot of the course is the same when you go to brew school. It's, you know, you're talking about fermentation, and wine and beer have similar fermentations, but your senior year you have to kind of specialize it, so the inferior students, they go into wine, and the superior students continue on studying beer.
Yeah.
And but we, you know, went that route, and then a lot of circumstances. And I was helping change the laws in the state of Nevada to allow brew pubs because it's illegal to have them. That was quite a fight. And then when we got that going, we opened up Great Basin in 1993 when I became an official brewmaster.
Okay. Really? Wow. I didn't know that was like that. Wow.
Yeah, I didn't know all those laws were.
Yeah, those laws is crazy. Boy, they need to get rid of some of them people that make laws. That's another show for itself.
Well, you can vote in November to do that.
My thing is this. So you've been doing it this long. You started off and you went on to do the brewing thing. You did it at UC Davis. You got down like that. And so now here you are in 2020 putting together some infused stuff that's going to make Great Basin a better, you feel a better brewery with another level of product?
Yeah, I mean, well, while we're not really, you know, producing it, but yeah, I mean, this partnership, I think, really nails home our commitment to innovation and really pushing what's possible.
Yeah, I've been to the lab and I've seen the hops and stuff.
Yes, but I do end up working with the hops, and it's great. Like, I open up the bag and the smell of the freshness. Yeah, the aromas just all over the room. And whenever I'm working with it, people come into the room. They're like, what are you doing? Because I can smell it. You know, the aromas just, because I'm working with the concentrate. So it's such a strong flavor, and it's IPA. So it's got all those flavors.
And it smells great.
Yeah, the hops are just fantastic.
I love it when you're sending it. Just keep sending it. They smell great. I don't even drink beer. I haven't drank beer in
I love beer.
40 years.
I love beer.
My friend of mine, I'll give you a quick story right quick. A friend of mine, I was 16 years old, and he had six-pack of Schlitz malt liquor. And he decided that he didn't want me to drink because he was like, you know, like a big brother to me. And I go, well, you got all this liquor in your house, but you're going to tell me I can't drink. You know, he said you were just 16. So what he did was he set me down with a six-pack of tall can Schlitz malt liquor and made me drink all of them. I got sick as a dog.
I mean, anybody would.
Yeah. So I've never touched another beer since then, since I was 16. But I love all of the stories I hear about what beer does to people. And I love the stories about, like, what you're doing. You're doing something different that takes it to another level. It's not, everybody's not doing that. Just like with me and the infused seasoning, you're taking hops to another level. You know what I mean? And, and that's why you're on this show, because I want everybody on this show that's doing something that nobody else is doing. And that's what you're doing. And I appreciate that. I really do. Bea, is there a difference between infusing the hops and infusing my seasoning?
There is a difference between infusing hops and infusing spices, simply because I'm working with two different
elements.
Yeah. So with the spices, it's a lot of solid, and I can't really work with the oil because then it'll just get sticky. The THC will just get all over it and won't spread evenly. Whereas with the hops, it's like you can just mix the hops because it's in liquid form, and the THC that I'm working with is in solid slash liquid form. So it's easier to mix those two. But with the hops, I also have to extract it through I use a CO2 machine. So the CO2 extraction method to just take the flavor of the hops. So I'm not getting the extracts of the hops. It's just all the flavor. When it comes out, you can smell the room, you know?
Mm. Yeah, we did that already.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did that. See how this conversation going, Garrett? We love your product. Can't you
That's
tell?
Really interesting.
Apparently, Bea loves playing with your product.
I love, you know, I really love craft breweries. So I love the craft beer. I don't just drink regular beer. If I'm going to get fat from the calories, I'm going to do it with something delicious, you know?
Yeah.
So I think it's a sort of art form that it's beautiful. Just watching these guys work, you know, I've gone to a brewery, not theirs, but it's amazing.
So I got a great question for Garrett. As the marketing man of the whole company, what has been your most difficult project with Great Basin?
You know, I can't pick a most difficult one, but I can pick the most fun one.
Okay, give me a fun one. Then. I love fun too. I'll take fun.
You know, that's been our new icky branding that we just came out with just a couple weeks ago, actually, and we had a local artist get involved and.
Oh boy!
It's bright, helpful. It's real fun. So, we're rolling that out now, and it's going to be hitting statewide here in the next few weeks.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you guys got that icky thing going on. So,
yeah.
Tell me a little bit more about that. I mean, a little bit more. I mean, elaborate on it just a little bit more for me. I'm not understanding what icky is.
Oh sure. So icky being our flagship IPA, our most popular. IPA. It's really our most popular beer.
Okay.
It's one of the most award-winning IPAs that we have internally, that we brew. It's been picking up awards left and right, even this year, which is something to be said for a beer that was first imagined back in 1993.
And it's still kicking it today. That's what else is the same thing with my seasoning. Love it. It's still kicking it. I love that part. And another thing I wanted to know, when it comes down to brewing, beer, when I see the different commercials or whatever, they got these big tanks. And what are those tanks? Those are like, do they pressure the beer? They cook it? What are those big giant tanks are that you guys have, that most beer companies, breweries have?
Well, you can have big tanks, small tanks, any kind of tanks, but these tanks, each one has a different purpose. And first of all, we have to make sugars because that's how fermentation happens. So the wine guys, they already start with sugar. They got grapes, they already sugar. But we start out with grain. So we have to make starch conversions, starch into sugars, and we use a certain heat rest that kick in the amylase, which makes that conversion. And then that one tank does that. Another tank, we have to boil this stuff and get some of those hops in there. And then it goes to another tank. We whirlpool and separate some things. And then we put another tank and ferment the beer. Another tank and finish it off. So there's a lot of different tanks that have different purposes.
What I'm getting into, what I'm trying to get at, is I'm trying to find out where the hop stuff come in. Where do the hops come in beer? Because the hops is what we're extracting to put the flavor and all that. Where does that come in when you make beer?
Yeah, that's a really interesting question. Because for all the 5,000-plus years that they're making beer, hops are not part of it. It's not essential for beer. We need barley and grain. And for all those years, you references all these weird herbs they're using, like mugwort, and even juniper, sweet gale, and all kinds of strange herbs they're putting into it. And
wow.
Somebody, about 500 years ago, which is fairly recent, this weird flower called the hop flower, and you get the kind of cannabis connection here, too, with the flowers are the the biggest part of it, things too, to throw that into some beer. And I don't know what they threw in before they threw in hops. Mm. But hops actually add some very interesting flavor characteristics and actually add some bitterness that balances the sweetness of the malt.
Oh, okay.
And so it works really well. So most beers have some hops over the last 500 years. But you get a lot of bitterness by boiling the hops for a long time, and that's nice. But then all that beautiful aroma, the air smells really good outside the brewery. We're boiling hops that smell good, but then we add hops at the end of the boil. Now we're getting more of those flavor in there, but the air still smells. Then we add hops in the fermenter when a beer is already down to room temperature and below that, and then we're getting really all those aromas stay in the beer. And so it's a lot of different hops.
When it comes down to beer and the processing of beer, is there certain temperatures you got to brew it at or cook it at? Or because I'm really interested in this beer thing, the brewing thing. It really sounds interesting. I just wanted to know, is there a certain temperature it got to be cooked at, or do you pressurize it? How you get the beer?
Well, you know, all of the above. We actually make a sugary liquid out of barley sugars, a complex sugar, and then we introduce a usually a culture yeast because it can control the flavors. And the yeast, every being on this earth wants to reproduce, and yeast is no exception. So what they need to get their excitement on and make more little yeast cells is sugar. And they turn that sugar into alcohol, carbon dioxide, B vitamins, and little yeast cells.
Mm-hmm.
That's how the beer, that's what we're doing, the fermentation tests and things. And temperatures are really, because when the yeast are reproducing, they need specific temperatures to grow at the proper and reproduce properly. And so we have to give them what they want, and that's why we have to control the temperatures quite clearly on fermentation like that.
All right. Well, we getting ready to run out of time. So what I want you to do, if you can, for our listeners, is give them the information how they can contact you and your website and your email, so that they can, if they want to be interested in contacting you about even your beer, what's that information?
Yeah, so you can hit us up at greatbasinbrewing.com, where we've got our website. We've got a contact form on there, you know, and we read each and every contact that comes through.
Okay.
And if there's any other questions, people want more info, please get at us and let us know.
Well, we really appreciate you coming on, Garrett. Any social media that you want to express?
Yeah. And we're on Facebook, of course, Instagram, Twitter, and Untapped for all those craft
Untapped.
I use Untapped.
Yeah. You got her on that one. Okay. Well, it was great, man, having you on the show today. Sorry that Stephanie wasn't here, but Bea came in her absence, and she did a great job. But we want to thank you. Man, look, I'm so happy that I got a chance to talk to a brewmaster. I mean, I just wanted to talk to somebody about beer because of the fact that I've never, after what my brother, you might as well call him my brother, did to me with that beer, I wanted to know why I got so drunk.
I think you need to give beer another chance. You know, people always tell me, like, why do you love beer so much? And you know, what's wrong with just drinking regular liquor? And I always have to tell them, you know, people don't hate beer. They just haven't found one they love yet.
That's right. That's right. That's what, well, see, well, I'm going to tell you, I got to tell you,
you
don't like Slits Malt Liquor Bull. I'll tell you this, Garrett, I will try Great Basin. I'll try it. I will do that. After all these years, over 40 years, I will try, because I'm 63. So, you know. Yeah.
This is not a business.
Yeah. So we're going to go ahead on and go. We really thank you guys for coming on and everything, and I appreciate it. Garrett, you have anything else you'd like to say to the people?
I just want to say out here, too, and give them a plug for the ichthyosaur research and the great scientific endeavors that we've done in the state. It's Springs Preserve there in Vegas.
Yeah, I know that.
Some of the fabulous ichthyosaurs on display, and that's what this beer is named after, and we've shortened it to Icky, but we're really, really proud to be great sponsors of ichthyosaur research and continuing our constant endeavoring search for the truth in beer and cannabis.
All right. See, that's what I wanted. That's that ending that I was looking for. Give me the day to make it right.
For more information on THC Productions, you guys can come visit thcproduction.com.
Soul Delicious Infused.com. And always listen in to 1.5 FM.
That's all we have for today. So thank you for listening in. And tune in next Saturday at 7:30 a.m. on KUNV 91.5.
Keep out of reach of children, for use only by adults 21 years of age and older. You have been listening to a paid program sponsored by Soul D’licious. Please be advised that the voices and opinions you've heard do not necessarily represent the views of KUNV Las Vegas, the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, or the Board of Regents of the Nevada System of Higher Education.